how investigators are conducting DNA tests. The goal, to identify the mystery man the district attorney says killed Victoria Martins. But it's easier said than done. Here's why. Bernalillo County District Attorney Raul Torres says his investigators found a partial DNA profile on the back of 10-year-old Victoria Martins. But his office will not say what type of DNA it is.
If it's a dried sample that was taken off of her back, anything that's dried, it could be there for a long time. If it's a wet sample, then eventually the DNA is going to start to degrade. So that can give you a time frame.
DNA expert Erica Everhart says the type of testing done is known as YSTR, which is only done on Y chromosomes. Those are only found in men.
There's a couple of kits that are out there and they target 23 areas of DNA.
But she says this is not the traditional testing where you can identify one person.
When that's been exhausted, as far as either there's too much of female DNA that it masks the male, or there isn't enough DNA to obtain a DNA profile.
In court documents filed by the DA's office, this is the DNA evidence they found. Everhart says out of the 23 areas, they were able to match 9.
Dealing with 9 out of 23, that's a little less than half, but still it's something that's better than nothing.
Here's the tricky part with YSTR testing. There is no database to compare samples, and it only identifies a unique paternal line of DNA, meaning the DNA a grandfather passes down to a son who then passes it down to his son. It does not identify an exact person. The district attorney's office says they are not going to talk about the number of samples being tested right now or the types of tests being analyzed. They say this is an ongoing investigation and they do not want to do anything to jeopardize it. For Target 7, I'm Sasha Leninger.